Hi everyone, it's Natasha here, otherwise known as Time Turner Required, and today I'm going to be giving basically an overview of how I plan within four different planners. This is an addendum to the blog post that I made on my Tumblr account, so I'll link that down below. Feel free to check that out. And without further ado, I'm going to get started, and hopefully what I'm imagining, this along with the Tumblr posts will become a bit of a series, kind of breaking down how I plan and in-depth looks inside each planner, and each blog post will or should have an accompanying video at some point. So I'll get started. I'm just going to quickly run through the four planners that I'll be talking about. And yes, I do use every single one of these on a daily basis. They're all in my backpack with me. So the first one, this is an A6, and it's just a notebook from Muji at the moment, but it's basically kind of meant to be a Hobonichi original Techo, which is an A6 size. So I'll be starting a Techo in the new year, so this is just to kind of play around with setups, uses, that kind of thing. The next is my black moleskin soft-covered squared bullet journal, and yep, I'll go through that. Then this one is my Midori undated weekly insert, and this is standing in for a Hobonichi weeks, and because I don't have one yet, I'll have one in 2017, but it's got the same layout, so again, I'm playing around with stuff. And last, but definitely not least, is my Hobonichi Avec Cousin July to December 2016, and I'll be going with the Cousin Avec for 2017 as well. So this was kind of purchased as a trial run. I've already got my 2017 cover on it, and I think from what you will gather from this video is I'm a huge fan of the Hobonichi. I found out about it from studying on YouTube and Tumblr. I'll link her stuff down below as well, and I was really intrigued at how she used it. And then I found a load of Facebook groups about it, and they are really lovely people, but they really like to enable and help you rationalize a lot of purchases from the Hobonichi website, which is basically exactly what I've done. So I'm just going to get started, and I'm going to start with my Cousin Avec, because this is my main planner, and it basically houses all of my to-dos and monthly spreads, and I use a bullet journal kind of system or setup in here. So and the reason why I use this and not a bullet journal is I can plan ahead with this, and I don't need to spend time drawing everything up, so it really makes a big difference. So this is my October at the moment. We're only a few days into it. It's the 7th today, and it's pretty hectic. I'm a full-time student, and I work three jobs, two of which are volunteer positions, one of which is a part-time job that really should be a full-time position. I'm a long-distance runner, so I train five times a week, and I live in a share house, which means I have to do kind of all the adulting stuff as well. So this is basically where all major things go that are coming up, or dates or times and stuff. I highlight really big things with washi tape, and events that last for more than a day. For example, Anti-Poverty Week is 17th to the 23rd of October. So I don't put really small things in there, but you know, I've got run training where I actually train with people as opposed to by myself. You know, I've got that I listed one of the rooms in my flat for lease. and all of that kind of stuff. So, and as I said, it lets me forward plan, so I've already got some stuff in for November, and even a little bit for December and January. So, the January stuff I'll definitely have to move over to the new Avex, but for now it just gives me a place to store it. So then I move into dailies, and because I got this in late August, I think it was, I used the July pages just for some Norwegian vocab. I'm learning Norwegian at the moment, so they're a good use. I got a fountain pen, which is very excited as I'm a left-hander, so I was just trying it out because the Tamoy River paper, which this is printed on, is said to be amazing for fountain pens, and it really is. So this is where I started with it, and yeah, as you can see, it's really kind of like a Bujo, a bullet journal. I use boxes and cross stuff, shade stuff in when it's done. You can see my colour code, and I actually swapped from using the Staedtler fineliners to, somewhere down the line, to Pilot Juice pens. And I much prefer those, and I use a bit of washi on the side because the Hobonichi has time scales. I like to kind of put in time sensitive events, but quite often, as you'll see, especially now, I've got so much stuff on, I literally don't have room to use the time scales. So that's why I'm really looking forward to 2017, because I'll have the weekly section in the Avex, so that will give me just a lot more room and breathing space on the daily pages. What else do I do? I started tracking my time, and some days I do it better than others, but I like doing it when I can, when I remember, and yeah, it's just nice to reflect and really see that I take a reasonable number of breaks, but I spend far too long on them. I also track my forest hours. So Forest is a great productivity app, and basically it completely shuts off your phone or shuts off certain sites on your computer. You can denote what kind of sites, and so basically each square represents 30 minutes that I've used Forest either on my phone or my computer. And I just turn it into a tree because Forest, that's nice. And once you get a certain number of points on Forest, you get to plant a tree, which is also really nice and exciting. So I just like, again, when I've actually used Forest and I remember to draw the tree in and I have time, I like being able to track it. So yeah, I still do some decoration. Again, when I have the time and I like it, like you can see this is pretty blank. And this wasn't because I was busy, this is because I was procrastinating. So it's a really good reminder for me to kind of be like, yeah, this was a bad couple of days. And then when I am busy, I just don't decorate, and you know, I'm happy with it like that. So just going to flip through a bit. I started journaling a bit in it, and it isn't really just journaling, it's more, I really want to try and get my procrastination under control. So this is literally me writing all about procrastination, or my procrastination and what I tried that day about it, what worked, what didn't work, what I can improve upon, that kind of thing. So as you can see, I normally just have the day all laid out, and then I write basically everywhere else at the end of the day. And now, instead of using the Pilot Juice, because it's just a lot of work to kind of constantly be swapping between 11 pens, which is my color code, I just use the black pen from the Hobonichi website. It's a multi pen, but I just use the black one. And then I highlight over it with my Zebra Mildliners, and it doesn't smudge and it makes it stand out really nicely, and it's easy because then I can scribble something down on the go and then highlight later to color code it. So it's journaling, bit of journaling, and this is actually my today, so I've got a lot done, and I still have quite a bit left to do. So, yeah, that's mainly, and you can see I've planned ahead a bit. So yeah, that is mostly how I use this, and basically if I had to choose between one planner, I would probably just stick with this. But as you will see soon, I need all of my planners, but this is definitely great. So next up is I've got my A6 mock-up, and it's basically just a lined notebook from Muji, and you can see, sorry, just trying to get this in focus. You can see there are tiny little lines at the top, so it makes it quite easy to draw in monthly boxes. So I've just kind of drawn it all in so it looks like the A6 original Hobonichi. And this is basically what I'm imagining it will be, is a notebook for notes from each of my three jobs. And they all kind of require different things I need to remember. At the moment, for one of my volunteer positions, I'm basically organising a national level conference. So at the moment, 90% of the book is just notes about that. And the reason why I'm not just doing this in any random notebook, but a dated one, is because then I can, there are two ways. I can be like, oh, I had a meeting on September 16th. What was said then? What to-dos are outstanding? And instead of kind of going into a Google Drive, looking for the minutes, I can just open up to the 16th of September here and be like, right, we discussed training sessions, we discussed this, we discussed that, and so-and-so had to post this to this on this date. Has it been done? Yes, it has. No, it hasn't. That kind of thing. So that's mostly what it is. Like today, I actually was taking some notes. I'm starting my thesis next year. So I was taking some notes on sources I need to get my hands on. A couple of blank pages. Doesn't really bother me because I know that at some point, notes are going to overflow from a day, so I can just thread it, which is basically writing down, let's say I fill up this page and I need to thread it, I'd write down that I was threading it to the 6th of October, flip back, start writing on the 6th of October. So that's how threading works, and it's a bullet journal technique again. I started off with a bullet journal, which is why I use so many techniques from that. And yeah, I use the monthly pages as a kind of an index, so like the main theme or topic for each day, and that's about it. So this is actually really helpful, and I wasn't sure whether I was going to use it, which was why I bought the A6 Muji to try it out before I placed an order on the Hobonichi site. But yeah, I really surprised myself how much I'm using it and how useful that it's been, and I've only been using it for about 3 weeks, so this is great. Next up, I've got my Midori undated weekly insert, and this is standing in for a week's, because a Hobonichi week's, because I don't own one yet, and the one that I've got coming to me will be for 2017. So the idea behind this is, when I used my bullet journal as a complete and utter bullet journal for scheduling and stuff, I wrote out weekly pages, and these were basically an overview of anything major, any appointments or something happening in my week. It wasn't really for to-dos, it was just anything major that I had to be aware of at a glance, and it just kind of really helped me, even just the writing out process, because then I had a really good idea of what was coming up in my week. And so, this is basically that, but not in my Bujo. And the reason I'm doing it in this is because I don't actually have to draw out the separate boxes and all of that, and it works. And plus, I get to buy another Hobonichi next year, which is really exciting, and my wallet is crying. So this is actually this week. As you can see, this is everything, all the meetings, all the activities, mostly time-sensitive stuff that I knew about in advance. And then basically all of the to-dos that I know that need to be done on a certain day and that I knew about before the week started. And yeah, so that's really useful. And then I've divided the other page into two columns. On the left is just stuff. So I like this as my catch-all. So let's say a professor gives us kind of homeworks and going to research. Instead of pulling out my whole cousin, I can just pull out my Midori and write it down here. And then whenever I get the chance, I can transfer that quick bullet point into whichever correct notebook it should go in, or the correct page, that kind of thing. On the right is meant to be my food tracking. Haven't been very successful, as you can probably tell. I did a bit better last week, but yeah, we'll see how that goes. I quite like the idea of, I did fitness tracking last week as well, like exercises, that kind of thing. And I quite like that I, track that. I just need to get better at it, but I've only had this since the 27th of September, so, you know, I haven't had it long, still figuring it out, but I think this is really good, and I definitely think I'll be sticking to it. So last but not least is my bullet journal, and I've had this one since June of this year, so, yeah, I started out with it like a completely normal bullet journal. You can see dailies, that kind of thing, bit of journaling. And, you know, you see the journaling in my Hobonichi now, but I try to do the majority of it in here just because Hobonichi is more productivity, brain screwed on tight, and this can be the, like, brain dumps of I don't know what. You can see I started time tracking in here before moving it over to my Hobonichi because I thought it would make a lot more sense it being linked to the day and seeing what I wanted to do that day in terms of to-dos and then what I kind of ended up doing time-wise. So this is mostly just collections, journaling, and brain dumps now. So every weekend without fail, I write down everything that needs to be done. And then I colour it in when it's done. Some journaling. This isn't tracking, so this is for my thesis. I have to read this book. It's in French, so needed a bit of motivation. And so yeah, I actually finished it, and this was the first book I ever voluntarily read and finished in French. So that was a big. That was exciting. I've got Christmas present ideas here. I'm not quite sure what's happening with that column because I've only got four people in my family that I'm mainly going to be buying gifts for. So yeah, mistakes happen, and they happen in everything. They happen in Bujos more often than not, but yeah, just something we have to accept. I've got an exercise tracker. This month, that was my mid-semester break, everything I had to get done. This month, again, the normal habit tracker. I've got no spend tracker that I haven't filled out for the 3 days. I've got morning routine, exercise tracker again, savings tracker, some more journaling, that kind of thing. So it's basically imagine a traditional Bujo and then take out monthly, weekly, and dailies. So I go through this a lot slower, which is nice because Moleskines are kind of expensive, so I get to keep this longer and I get to use my wonderful Hobonichis. So that's it. Four planners on a daily basis. They all come with me everywhere I go. I probably shouldn't do that, but I've got attachment issues, and sometimes I've tried to leave my bullet journal at home or something, and I've ended up needing it. So I just take it all with me. It doesn't really make much of a difference because I carry them all in a big backpack anyway. The way I carry it is I've actually got my weekly in here, the week, as well as my A6. I just slot that in there. So that's kind of all one thing. And because it's the Avec, it all fits in pretty well. And then I've got my Bujo separately. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please let me know in the comments if you have any questions about how I plan or want me to go more in depth about something in a blog post or a video or both. And if you like this, please like the video and subscribe. Thank you. Bye.